Simulated Annealing. This course is brought to you by Gilad Jain's Mystery School. Learn more at giladjains.com. Introduction. Simulated annealing has been applied to a wide range of problems, combinatorial and continuous optimizations. This work approaches a new class of problems in which the objective function is discrete but the parameters are continuous. This type of problem arises in rotational irregular packing problems. It is necessary to place multiple items inside a container such that there is no collision between the items, while minimizing the item's occupied area. A feedback is proposed to control the next candidate probability distribution, in order to increase the number of accepted solutions. The probability distribution is controlled by the so-called crystallization factor. The proposed algorithm modifies only one parameter at a time. If the new configuration is accepted, then a positive feedback is executed to result in larger modifications. Different types of positive feedbacks are studied herein. If the new configuration is rejected, then a negative feedback is executed to result in smaller modifications. For each non-placed item, a limited depth binary search is performed to find a scale factor that, when applied to the item, allows it to be fitted in the layout. The proposed algorithm was used to solve two different rotational puzzles. A geometrical cooling schedule is used. Consequently, the proposed algorithm can be classified as simulated quenching. This work is structured as follows. Section 2 presents some simulated annealing and simulated quenching key concepts. In Section 3, the objective function with discrete values and continuous parameters is explained. Section 4 explains the proposed adaptive neighborhood based on the crystallization factor. Section 5 explains the computational experiments and Section 6 presents the results. Finally, Section 7 rounds up the work with the conclusions. Background. Simulated annealing is a probabilistic meta-heuristic with a capacity of escape from local minima. It came from the Metropolis algorithm and it was originally proposed in the area of combinatorial optimization, that is, when the objective function is defined in a discrete domain. The simulated annealing was modified in order to apply to the optimization of multimodal functions defined on continuous domain. The choices of the cooling schedule and of the next candidate distribution are the most important decisions in the definition of a simulated annealing algorithm. The next candidate distribution for continuous variables is discussed herein. In the discrete domain, such as the traveling salesman and computer circuit design problems, the parameters must have discrete values. The next point candidate xk plus 1 corresponds to a permutation in the list of cities to be visited, interchanges of circuit elements, or other discrete operation. In the continuous application of simulated annealing, a new choice of the next point candidate must be executed. Bohachevsky et al. Propose that the next candidate xk plus 1 can be obtained by first generating a random direction vector u, with vertical bar u vertical bar equals 1, then multiplying it by a fixed step size delta r, and summing the resulting vector to the current candidate point xk. Brooks and Verdini showed that the selection of delta Ries a critical choice. They observed that an appropriate choice of this parameter is strictly dependent on the objective function fx, and the appropriate value can be determined by presampling the objective function. The directions n are randomly sampled from the uniform distribution and the step size is the same in each direction. In this way, the feasible region is explored in an isotropic way and the objective function is assumed to behave in the same way in each direction. But this is not often the case. The step size to define the next candidate point xk plus 1 should not be equal for all the directions, but different directions should have different step sizes, i.e. the space should be searched in an anisotropic way. Khurana et al. Explored the concept of anisotropic search. They proposed a self-tuning simulated annealing algorithm in which the step size is configured in order to maintain a number of accepted solutions. At each iteration k, a single variable of sk is modified in order to obtain a new candidate point xk plus 1, and iterations are subdivided into cycles of n iterations during which each variable is modified. The new candidate point is obtained from sk in the following form: xk plus 1 equals xk plus v delta ri, where vis a uniform random number n, and delta res the step size along direction a off the ith axis. The anisotropy is obtained by choosing different values of delta ri for all the directions. The step size is kept fixed for a certain number of cycles of variables, and the fraction of accepted moves in direction a is calculated. If the fraction of accepted moves generated in the same direction is below 0.4, then the step size delta Y along A is decreased. It is assumed that the algorithm is using two large steps along ETHIS causing many moves to be rejected. If the fraction is between 0.4 and 0.6, the step size is left unchanged. If the fraction is above 0.6, then delta Rhys increased. It is assumed that the step size is too small, thus causing many moves to be accepted. This procedure may not be the best possible to process the different behavior of the objective function along different axes. Inger proposed that the random variable should follow a Cauchy distribution with different sensitivities at different temperatures. The maximum step size is kept constant during the algorithm and it allows escaping from local minima even at low temperatures. The parameter space can have completely different sensitivities for each dimension, therefore the use of different temperatures for each dimension is suggested. This method is often referred to as very fast simulated reannealing, VFSR, or adaptive simulated annealing, ASA. The sensitivity of each parameter is given by the partial derivative of the function with relation to the ith dimension.